non-conventional sources of energy. The energy based upon the exhaustible sources, such as the coal, petroleum, natural gas. Natural gas, they will not last long. So therefore, the some of the efforts done by the people to obtain as energy from inexhaustible sources. Inexhaustible sources. These sources of energy cover the solar energy, tidal energy, geothermal energy, biogas plants, and wind energy. The use of these sources of energy produce is fairly new and recent in time. Clear are the non-conventional sources of energy. The use of these sources of energy production is fairly newer and recent in time. These resources are eco-friendly, cheaper, non-exhaustible, pollution-free. These resources can help in solving the shortage of power in future. They will keep the environment safe and clean. They will check as the global warming goals. India is blessed with the abundant of non-conventional sources of energy due to its tropical and subtropical climatic conditions. The Tropic of Cancer, which passed through the mid of the country, divides India into two different heat zones as a tropical and subtropical. So tropical conditions are favorable for growth of a non-conventional sources of energy. Non-conventional sources of energy, in which as a first as a solar energy. Solar energy. So as for the tropical conditions of India, there is abundance, enormous possibilities for a growth of solar energy. There is an ample potential for production and utilization of solar energy. Solar energy has generally worked through the photovoltaic technology, PHOTOVOLTAIC. Photovoltaic technology used for a conversion of insulation into electricity. Photovoltaic technology used for a transformation of insulation into the electricity. It is especially popular in rural areas and smaller towns where the people are facing the trouble in relation to the power supply, erratic power supply. The largest solar power plant located at the Bhagwanpur of Neemuch in Madhya Pradesh. Bhagwanpur, Neemuch district of Madhya Pradesh. Generally, as the solar energy used for cooking, pumping and heating water, street lighting, now presently as a modification in a vehicles, automobiles. Except Madhya Pradesh, the other number of solar panels are located at Bias in Punjab, Shirdi in Maharashtra, associated with the generation of electricity through the incoming solar radiation, and fourth as Ladakh, solar energy. Next, as the tidal energy. Second, non-conventional sources of energy, tidal energy. India's long coastline, which has extended from Gujarat to the West Bengal. Gujarat to West Bengal, favorable for growth of a tidal energy. What's the length of it? Yes, rule number six from a 10th D. Rule number six from both the sections, C and D, raise your hands. Rule number six from 10th C and 10th D, raise your hands. That showed their presence. The total length of a DAT coastline of India is a 77516.6 kilometers long coastline, which has located 7516.6 kilometers long coastline, which has extended from the, it is extended from Gujarat, coast of Gujarat, Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Orissa, and West Bengal. 7516.6 kilometers long coastline, supportive for a growth of a tidal energy in India. Tidal energy in India. Through as the such coastline, tides, which are as the diurnal process. Tides are the diurnal process in which as a water level rises in a twice in a day. Daily water level of sea and ocean rises and falls due to the gravitational pull of sun and moon. That water rises and falls. Under such circumstances, if the turbines located on a coastal regions, when that water which rises during as a high tides, it will strike over a such turbines with rotation, we can generate as electricity. Oceanic tides in coastal areas can help to generate electricity. At initial stages, such kind of energy, it will be as expensive. But when we are talking about the longer in duration, under such circumstances, it will be as the cheaper. In long run, it will be as the cheaper mode of the generation of electricity. Cheaper mode of generation of electricity through which we can complete our needs of energy. So in floodgates, dams are built. In floodgates, where during high tides, water accumulated. Floodgates, it helps to stop the flow of a water. Such floodgates are built across the inlets. During as a high tides, water flows into the inlets and gets trapped. When the gate is closed after the tide falls outside the floodgate, the water retained by the floodgate flows back to the sea via a pipe that carries it to a power generating turbines. So with the rotation of a turbines, we can generate the electricity. So in a shorter tenure of time, it needs as a more capital investment, but for a long run, such kind of a turbines, they can work for completing our power requirement. In India, there is only as a one place is associated where the tidal energy has generated. It's the Gulf of Kutch, where 900 megawatt every year electricity generates with the help of a tides. In our country, tidal energy as the potential resource, which may as increase in future. Due to as availability of other sources of energy in our country, hydroelectricity, thermal power stations, nuclear power stations, solar energy, geothermal energy, we are less emphasizing over the tidal energy. But in near in future, when the other sources of energy means as a thermal power stations, they will stop as their production. Under such circumstances, the use of a tidal energy, it will start to increase. Clear? Third, non-conventional sources of energy as the wind energy. The potential areas of producing the wind energy in India are the Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Keral, Karnataka and Lakshadweep. Karnataka and Lakshadweep. In Tamil Nadu, it has the largest wind farm cluster located at Nagarcoil. N-A-G-A-R-C-O-I-L. Nagarcoil. In Tamil Nadu, Nagarcoil near the Madurai, associated with the India's largest wind farm located. Wind farm located in a Nagarcoil of a Madurai. As compared to this, as a desert conditions, dry conditions of a Rajasthan and Gujarat and coastal regions of India are also supportive for location of a windmills. Another well-known place is as the Jaisalmer, where the wind farm is India's second largest wind farm is located. It is as fulfilling the requirement of a local power for domestic and agricultural purposes. Clear? Domestic and agricultural purposes. Next, third form of a non-conventional sources of energy as the geothermal energy. Geothermal energy. It refers to the heat and electricity produced by using the heat from the interior of the earth. Underground water in active volcanic regions gets heated in contact with heated rocks. Steam pressure builds and rises to earth's surface. This steam energy can be converted into the electricity. Presently, as a geothermal energy has used at a very smaller in scale, only in a Himachal Pradesh. In Himachal Pradesh, hot springs in India can be used for generating the electricity. The two experimental projects have been set up, first in a Parvati Valley near the Manikaran in Himachal Pradesh. Parvati Valley near Manikaran in Himachal Pradesh, and second one is the Pugha Valley of Ladakh. Pugha Valley, P-U-G-A. Pugha Valley in Ladakh in Jammu and Kashmir, associated with the geothermal energy. Generally, when the earthquakes are originate in epicenters, such kind of the warm water springs or geysers, they opened on a surface. They opened on surface in where the epicenter of earthquake is located, in such areas as in those areas, hot water, warm water springs are outlet on a surface of the earth crust through which we can generate, we can transform that into the electricity. But presently, as a due to the less capital investment and more substitutes are available, geothermal energy as a minimally used in a Himachal Pradesh only. I'm again repeating, as a geothermal energy, it refers to the heat and electricity produced with the internal heat of the earth. Through the internal heat of the earth, when we generate electricity, is known as a geothermal energy. Is known as the geothermal energy. Internal heat of the earth, it helps for the generation of electricity. So underground water in active volcanic regions helps for a generation of electricity because the steam emits from such volcanic areas. Warm water or the steam emits from interiors of the earth, supportive for generation of electricity. This steam can be converted into the electricity. Example, Pugha Valley of Ladakh and Parvati Valley of Manikaran in Himachal Pradesh, associated with the geothermal energy. Geothermal energy. Next, as a biogas. Biogas. Farm waste, human waste, animal dung are used for producing the biogas for domestic consumption in rural areas. Decomposition of organic matter yields gas with more thermal efficiency than kerosene charcoal or the other forms of energy. Biogas plants can be set up at the cooperative and the individual levels. Such gobar gas plants exclusively using the cow dung in rural areas produce the gas, and afterwards the production of a gas, the remaining slurry liquid form of a cow dung, it can be as used for a increase the fertility of a land as a manure of a soils, for which as we can use as a raw material. So such gas plants, they give as a double benefits in the form of energy and manure also. In rural areas, such kind of a gobar gas plants are located with support of a cooperative societies and government support. Government giving as the 60-40% of the support. Thank you, Jesse. Okay. So we through such efforts, we can save as the energy minerals for future generations. First, as we have to use the substitutes of non-conventional sources of energy. As compared to the conventional sources of energy, we have to minimize the wastage of energy minerals at extraction, production, and consumption level. We must use as our limited energy resources in a planned and judicious way. We have to use as a more public transport comparatively our individual. Next, we have to check upon the equipments regularly. So through these ways, we can save our energy minerals for the future generations. Clear? This was our chapter, Minerals and Energy Resources. From this chapter, it will be not evaluated in a board examination. It will not evaluate in a board examination. Yes, Daksh, you want to ask something? Daksh? This chapter, it will not assess in a board examination, but from this chapter, the MAP matter, it will be as a ask in a board. MAP. And that MAP, it will be regarding as the identify the place. Place, it will be as a marked on a map related with as the hint will marked in a question paper. You have to identify that place. So for which as you have to familiar. Koderma is associated with a mica. It is associated with mica. Which one of the following minerals is contained in the monazite sand as the thorium? As thorium. Thorium. Next, distinguish between as the following ferrous and non-ferrous. From the chapter, you have to only attempt as answer the questions briefly on your notebooks. Answer the questions briefly on your notebooks. On your notebooks. Clear? So any questions related with the chapter? Related with the chapter.